Okay, so here we are. Bingo update number two. Okay, I called the bank. There's two banks in my area, but I was dealing with the one that wasn't overseeing my account because they're a bigger bank, so I figured they'd have more power. So that's the lady I went and visited this morning. So I called their branch and I asked them, I said, did all those checks get paid? She said the only one that got paid was the electric company. The one for the license plates, the one for the insurance got returned. And I says, well, can you get me the guy who can stop that? Can you give me his number? She said, well, it's all run by computer. It's just automatic. I said, well, someone has to press the button for the computers. Can you give me a name? Well, I finally, she said, well, let me give you the name for the branch where your account is, and the in-store branch. I says, no, I want your district manager. I want your boss's number. But your account's over at that store. I said, no, I want your number. That's all I want is your boss's number. And she says, here it is. And she finally, and I said, see how easy that was? And she says, I'm just an employee chained at the desk. And I said, I'm not trying to intimidate you. I just want your district manager's number. And, you know, everything, you know. And I felt like a judge on a bench because I had to interrupt her. I says, okay, so you gave me two phone numbers and one name. And she starts saying, well, your branch number, da da da. And I says, you didn't answer my question. You just gave me two numbers and one name, right? Yes. Okay, that's all I wanted to know. I feel like a judge on the bench, man. It's kind of cool feeling like a judge on the bench, but I ended all nice, and you know, sometimes you got to get in there and interrupt. One thing I learned from someone who's studying psychology, when you got someone who's speaking 100 miles an hour at you, and they just won't stop when you try to interrupt them, especially when you're the customer, they should automatically stop. If your customer's always right, man, you should always stop when the customer's talking. But she said, the guy told me, studying psychology, he says, if someone's running their mouth and you can't get it word in edgewise, he says, start talking real fast for a few words. Just do something like this. And it'll stop them. And then interject and talk slowly. So I had to do that with her. I said, I just want your boss's number. So please, you know, basically the idea. But I tried the technique and it worked. I just want your, it works. So anyway, I called my branch over here and asked for the district manager. And they were happy to give me. I didn't tell them the story. They were just happy to give me the number. And so I called, and he wasn't there. And it's weekend. It's Friday, Valentine's Day weekend, all that. But on his number, he said, there's an emergency contact. Call this woman. So I called her, and there wasn't anything there. But I did end up putting on her message. I said, there, you know, give me an email quick. Get back with me quick. If you're checking your messages here over the weekend or whatever, you need to get back with me quick, please. Here's my email because there's an investigation. I've started an investigation. I did not tell them what kind of investigation it was, but the investigation is a military investigation. That's CID at the IRS, Criminal Investigation Department, CID. They're the ones with the gun. That means military. You understand that? And that's international military at the highest level. So, all right. So Monday, I'm going to go talk to the DMV. I'm going to go talk to the insurance agents that's right around the corner here. And I'm going to tell them what's going on, that there's a criminal military investigation, international military. It's international military investigation going on. So you might want to, for the sake of the public safety, even though I don't need no public insurance, I got an insurance bond that will cover everything. But I got the international military investigating this. I just sent a registered letter off today, and we're going to take care of the whole enchilada. So for the sake of your public safety, make this insurance good. even though I don't need it. Because if I need to, I can write a promissory note. And with the law of attraction, I ain't getting in no accident. I'm the safest driver out there on the road. Because I run the whole planet with this brain. And then and at the highest levels, they're picking this brain running the planet. So, because I know who I am. But so I'll talk to the DMV also Monday, and I'll let them know that there is an international military investigation going on. So you know, keep what you're doing and go with your regular 45-day program with your plates, and you know, everything's good, and make sure that permit on my back of my window, the temporary permit, is still good. You know, because what can happen is they can say, well, the check's returned, they'll call the sheriff or the cops possibly, and then they could actually just come to the house and look at the car and see that it's, you know, expired, whatnot, knock on the door, and then I'd have to explain to them all over what's going on. So, but that's not going to happen, because Monday I am going to go to the DMV, because I'm a man who takes care of things right now when it gets down to the nitty-gritty of the business. When the priority is at stake and needs to be taken care of, I'm there. When it comes down to the money system, the credit system with the birth certificate, and, you know, to the nitty-gritty, because public hazard is at stake. You know, I wrote checks to them. They're expecting money. All their business and safety depends on public money, which is fake money anyway, put in their accounts so that they don't go off the deep edge and start doing stuff like calling their authorities unnecessarily. So if I can avert all that, having to call around and bring other people into the situation, third party, fourth party, fifth party, next thing you know, there's 10 parties involved in the whole thing just because we didn't take the responsibility to nip it in the bud right now, man. And that responsibility grows in you. It becomes instinct. You know, because you're totally for peace and safety, you know what it takes, man. You know how to get down, because national emergencies, man, national emergencies, you got to have someone who understands what a national emergency is. That's war, man. You got to be able to get on your horse and say, we're riding now. We're taking care of the problem right now. That's what national emergency, that's what war is all about. Even though we have the physical war out here still, the main war is the paper war. The physical war is dying out, man. It's stopping, coming to an end. It's the paper war. And that's our commercial lien security agreements, signing ourselves out of the prison system. And this is a military Muther Flukin commanding general right here of the international military, right here, private top dog. You're looking at him right here, who knows how to take care of things right now. And it's all being recorded in Washington, D.C., New York, where the Iroquois land is at, spread throughout The Hague and everything. That I'm being recorded, everything I say, and they key off everything I say because they know that I am from the tribe of Judah, the bloodline of King David, and the Iroquois Indians who were undefeated in the North American when they took over the trail chairs of the Cherokee, private side of the Cherokee is the Iroquois, and that's where I'm from. That's New York, the land sitting over there. So I am top dog sitting on the throne of King David. I run everything on this planet. When you understand bloodlines and everything and who you are and it comes to you, that's it. All right? There ain't no shame in knowing who you are. We're all equal because I am just a representative of bringing this prison planet to a final help everybody get signed out so that we can start to be at the same level. King of Kings is for a reason. The phrase King of Kings is for a reason. It's to help people to be a king, not to keep them down. To bring them up. And that's what I'm all about. Fairness, justice, equity, you name it. Mercy and the level playing field. Let everybody know exactly what the game is. Because I know how to say it without people having to write about it. I have that way, that gift to explain things. To keep everybody calm. That's why I'm in control. Not control, but that's why I'm overseeing everything. That's why they key off this brain. When I say they, I'm talking about the President of the United States, who runs the whole earth. He's the military enforcement of the whole earth. All right? And for all the other kings on the earth and the nations. All right? So the chain of command is me, Obama, royal family, and then next in line is probably Russia or China, and the chain of command goes down like that, all the different nations, all right? Okay, so that's update, bingo, update number two. I have called the big guns in. I have called, and Mother Nature showed me the signs. The military is now involved. It's already in the mail, certified. It's on its way with my intentions. It's coming. Babies. And I say babies, I mean lovingly, like just a good old phrase. It's coming, babies. It's coming, babies. It's coming. I'm not calling you babies. That's just a common phrase. It's coming, babies. It's coming. I could just as well say, it's coming, people. It's coming. It's here, man. But it's elevating now. Because I finally called the military. Yeah. All right. Talk to you later. Well, yeah. Next video, I'll just do some guitar. All right, let's stop this one, get on the record.